everybody. Welcome back. We're working with the Stampin Up Holiday Catalog. We're at the end of August 2020. We're going to start with page 32, the Wishes and Wonder Bundle. And it has dies and a stamp set. It's very pretty. Stamp set looks like this. Got the sleigh and a deer stamp special delivery. Nice long sentiment right here. A to and a from, which is always nice. I really like the North Pole stamp. You can put that on the back of your envelope and a nice greeting. And then the dies, two different deer. One, can you see it's embossed? We're gonna use him today. So he has a little texture to him. And then also a solid one that will cut out the stamped image. A really nice tag. I really like this little stitching detail down here at the bottom. Cuts out the sleigh and the mistletoe. Also has this one that will cut out all these dots, which I assume would be for the holly berries for these little leaves up here, and then some nice layering circles for tags and things. Before I show you mine, I have to show you this card. This is done by one of my team, Debbie Mookie in Wisconsin. And I mean, it's just perfection. I love this card so much. So it's a black card base, and then she's got the crumb cake here, and then vanilla, and the special delivery stamp right here. Then she took the black tag and she added, we're gonna use this today too, the frost white, kind of splotch that around with a little bit of water. So it really gave a really cool background on the black cardstock. A copper deer and silver leaves. And then this right here, she also, she punched it, she stamped it and punched it and then layered it on top of the tag. Can you see that? So this is stamped right here and then this is layered on top. So it kind of shows the whole thing. I don't know, I love it. I love everything about it. It's such a great card. I cannot improve on, I cannot improve for a sample for this set. I like hers better than mine, but let me show you what we're gonna make today. After I built it up. So, this is what we're going to make today. So I'm using gold as my mixed metal. We've got a little jingle bell in here, which you can substitute if you're going to mail and you don't want to, you know, mail something like that. It's a pretty set. It's a pretty card. A lot of you already have tags type things at home, or you can make a tag, and many of you already have deer. So this layout would work for lots of different stamp sets. So I started with Pear Pizzazz, and I ran the embossing folder with the trees through it. And they are hard to see, and you know, we've used this before. And what I like to do is take my sponge roller and gently, ever so gently, just rub a little bit across the trees. And you can even just rub in one direction, and all you're doing is just adding a hint of color on there. You really don't want to over sponge it because then it starts to look too crafty. Okay, you know, we talk about crafty tacky. We don't want it to be crafty tacky. We still want it to be pretty. So if you just go in one direction and ever so slightly, you'll start to see those trees come alive. And a little bit goes a long way. I don't even have to ink up very much. And then you'll start to see those kind of pop up. And so on this one, I didn't. And if you get the card in person, you're definitely gonna see the trees. But I'm gonna try this and see how it looks just to have a little bit extra on here. And some of it's gonna get covered up by the tag, so I don't have to go too crazy. But I'm just barely burnishing and rubbing right there just to make them pop up a little. And that was Pear Pizzazz. You could also just do Versamark. There's a lot of techniques you can do with the folder, but that's just a quick and easy one. So here is my tag. I use that Tis the Season paper. It's just, this is just red with a little pattern on it, and it looks really pretty. And we're gonna take two of these little guys that I cut out in Pear Pizzazz. And right here on the back, I'm gonna take a glue dot and just put one glue dot there and one here, just because they're little and I don't want a lot of oozy glue or anything. So this is, I just want just the tops. And right there, right up to that hole, hit for the tag. And this, so this part's a little fussy. We get a little fussiness going on because it is a little bit more involved with the bell, and You know, it's going to take a little dexterity to get these on. And the gold cord. So I'm going to take about 3 inches. And the bells come in like a cherry cobbler and a shaded spruce or garden green. Kind of, they could go either way. And gold. And I'm just taking a gold bell, running it through, kind of pulling it tight. I want it to pinch right there. Okay, so it's just hanging there. That's going to go through the hole. Okay, and then kind of let it, we're going to let it dangle right there. Turn this over, and we're going to hold that down with a dimensional. So that's what's going to hold our tag down and hold that. So I've got a dimensional here, here, and here. And we're going to put that right here. Oops, you know what I need to do before that? I need to put this greeting on. So I stamped this on vanilla with early espresso. So I need to do that first. Put this on, and this is 3/4 of an inch wide, my little thing here. Almost forgot to do that. And I'm gonna stick this right here. Now I'm gonna do that before I tie my bow on. Now, before I do the bow and do this, I'm going to do the splattering. So we're gonna take the frost white that's still in the catalog. I think we have silver and white, but the frost white is really pretty for just a little bit of snow. Take your aqua painter and get a little water going and pick some up and just give it a little tap. And if you get too much water, it can look not so great. Oops, I just splattered this poor guy over here. So it's just gonna give a little bit of snow sparkle, and it looks really pretty in person. And as an alternative, you can also do your Winkostella and get a little bit of that going, and you can do a little gold sparkle on it also. All right, we're gonna let that dry, and while that's drying, I'm gonna do the bow. So about 8 inches of twine, and I'm gonna slide this under my bell, right there, and then I can tie this on while I'm waiting for this to all dry. So try not to touch anything. Here we go. Tie it in a tight little knot. And then remember how you do your bow. So you're gonna, like you're tying a pair of shoes, except don't go this way, go around the back, and it will behave better. All right, twine has its own mind. It's just, it's like a cat. Sometimes it'll come to you and it's all friendly, and other times it says, nah, I really don't want to. So kind of, you gotta be the boss. Trim that up. Okay, now we can add the deer. There you go. Now you can see him. See how he's got texture, and he has an eye. You can see the eye and his nose. So, and even, it's got some nice detail on him. So even if you don't want to stamp him, so, and I have dimensionals back here, and we're just going to stick him right here, and I'm going to glue this to a red card with a little bit of espresso. Now, I was texting with my friend Betsy this weekend. She's having trouble with a seal, and I've heard some people have trouble, and I can't figure out what I'm doing that I don't have trouble. I've watched different videos, and some people are doing crazy things with their wrist and doing all... I don't know. I don't do that. I'm trying to pay attention to what I do. I come down, and if you pull straight up, it takes the tape off too far, and then you have to advance it with your thumb. Okay? So when I come down, I do give a slight check, but it's not... for heaven's sakes, I don't know what I'm doing, but I love it, and I don't have a problem with it. So... all I can say is just pull, and there is a slight check, not a big one, just a slight to make it stop. I don't know how to describe it. I love it though, but I hate to hear that some people are having trouble with it. So all I can say is keep trying. Okay. And then it's just a slightly stark without the rhinestones. So we're going to put those red rhinestones, the ones that I always say best value in the annual catalog. So I don't like that splotch. I'm going to cover that splotch up. and a couple of red rhinestones scattered about right there. And that's it. I think it's pretty. And I also think you could do this in a light blue and change this to red and green. There's a lot of red and green papers, as long as it's not too strong. But I really like the bell on it with the gold. And I love the splatter. And this is what I did on the inside. On the inside, I stamped the greeting. I added, there's three of those dies, so I added the third one here because I thought, well, I want to do something with it. This is the deer cut out, although you could just stamp him right there. And then the same paper with a little bit of gold right there. It's pretty. And a little more splatter. You want to do your splattering before you stamp, because otherwise, if you do it after, the water will mix with the ink and it could blur. So we don't want to do that. So there it is. Special delivery from Santa. All right. We'll see you next time. See it, learn it, stamp it.